Hi Justin, I thought that it might be better if I just make a film real quick to show you what we're thinking of. Just a little background information. We are getting a brand new kind of a service. It's called EBSCO Discovery Service, and it's basically going to be this box right here. I'm not sure what it's going to look like, but it's probably going to look something like this or like the examples I'm going to show you over the next few minutes. It's going to include a one search of all of our resources, and people will have the option to maybe hit other tabs depending on what is built for us by EBSCO, which is one of our database companies. We're going to have to do a redesign of our website for this. This particular box, which they are supposed to be making a widget for, that's going to be the easiest part in that you'll be able to drop it into the website that you're creating. What that website's going to look like, though, is what we have to work on. I'm going to show you some examples. This is Worcester State, which is using EBSCO Discovery Service. It's also a member of our consortium. The reason why I'm starting with them is many of the sites have a bar across the top with a drop-down menu, and I don't know how that's going to work with our BCC library or BCC website format. But this has Worcester has a really interesting feature, which is they have this right here, which is a drop-down menu that appears very easily off the side. Well, I don't know how easily, because you're the one that may have to come up with this, but this might work better with our existing BCC template. So this is a feature that I like. I also like these kind of click-through boxes. They happen to be images of books. I don't know if we have the software to be able to do something like this, but it is certainly something that I've seen on a lot of websites, just like this little widget over here. So some of the design features would be, to have our services, and then we would link this over to LibGuide, so you don't have to worry about that next step. It's just the landing page. Images like this is like recent acquisitions, and then have something like an Ask Us, and then either a subject guide or something down here that we can, because we're still working this out in the library, include some of those items that I mentioned in my email to you that we might want to keep. And then, of course, the contact information. This website is Williams College, and they also subscribe to the EBSCO Discovery Service search box. And their search box looks a little different, which, again, I don't know what ours is going to look like, but again, it does have to be front and center. They put an image of their library behind it, which is kind of neat, but hopefully this is what EBSCO will be creating. They have also, rather than a drop-down box, they have using the library, and a drop-down box appears, but it doesn't interfere with what might be our BCC template if we use something like this. And it includes things like hours and, faculty information, other resources like borrowing interlibrary loan, because that's something we definitely would want to have front and center too. Just scroll down here. Forms, reserves, doing research is probably, or it is actually the information about, our research guides, finding course reserves. So these are all things that we do use. Again, we can key these in after. The ideas, what I'm hoping to do is give you ideas for, what it is that we're looking for. And then we can, we could drill down after Richard and I and some of the library staff meet together to decide what needs to be on this page about us. Has stuff about the library staff. So this is kind of a nice example because these will close up, and what I'm also hoping to have is as much above the fold as possible. And then they have other things here which we may or may not use. What else is good here? The hours, and then need help. This could be like maybe an image for Zoom, that sort of thing. So that's another example. This is a simple example. It's North Shore Community College. It's a Massachusetts community college. They have, of course, the EBSCO Discovery Box. And they were able to put in a few extra things in here, which I still have to find out from EBSCO if I can do, because that would alleviate my having to have information in, you know, different places. I mean, if I can include more stuff in the Discovery Box. Theirs, they stretched out, which, I mean, I think the way the widget is going to work is you'll be able to decide how big or small it is on your page. And then they have this help area here. They have kind of a, oopsie-daisies, didn't mean to do that. Okay. I started it back up. It turns out that clicking some of these images will take you to them, take you to a LibGuide page. Rather than have a drop-down box, they have some things down here about the library. Is a feature I could see here, and then faculty toolkit. So again, there can be categories down below. These are pretty small. Now I have minimized this so I can kind of show you as much as possible without having to do a lot of scrolling. This is another example. This is the City University of New York, or City Community College of New York, rather. They have drop-down boxes, and I don't know if this is going to be a problem with our current Berkshire Community College template, but that's why I'm showing you these kind of last. But again, these are the kinds of things that we, you know, might want to have. You know, not necessarily everything that's here, and I wouldn't want as much stuff, but, you know, maybe it's better to have it on the side like Williams College had it. But you could see there's different categories, and I think we'd probably be interested in something like research, services, faculty, and about, and an Ask Us page. Perhaps on the side. This is a nice feature because these are, you know, like tiles, and they will take you out. If I click this, it probably takes me to a LibGuide of some sort. It looks like, it might be a LibGuide. I'm not sure. This may actually be an internal guide, but anyways, you don't have to worry about that. It's just the first page that you have to be concerned about, and then whatever guides it links out to, we would be creating. So just like we have our LibGuides right now. But again, you know, it's the idea is having something that's kind of above the fold and includes those important links that we need. Now, what I don't see here is I don't see an Ask Us. Let's see. Yeah, that's kind of, that has the, you know, it takes you to a page that has the chat and the email. But we would really like to have something that's up front with the Zoom. So, you know, maybe we'd have a tile that says Zoom and that sort of thing. Here's another example. This is Simmons University out in Boston. They also have the EBSCO Discovery box here. There's looks again. They always look a little different. This one does. I like these features a lot. Find and borrow, research and study about. We don't need the university archives, but this could live in a side box, kind of like the I think it was Williams College had. Because again, I'm not sure what the BCC template. You may have to have whatever your top area is. That real estate might, you know, that might be really important to keep, and therefore we can't have a drop-down box. But these are nice categories to have, because find and borrow seems to cover a lot of the areas that we would be interested in, research and study and about. And then quick links, this is pretty straightforward. We might want to have different ones, but like meet with a librarian could be the Zoom. Course reserves is important. Interlibrary loan, those are things we need. We probably would want the OCLC in here, although maybe we could put that in. I'll have to find out from EBSCO. But again, you know, and all of these, you will have noticed that search box is front and center. You know, like, you know, again, that's that widget we're going to get eventually, so that we can give to you. But what we're hoping to do is to start the process of designing this in advance, so that there, when we finally get that widget, you could just drop it in and it'll be ready to go. And I'm sorry, I can't give you more information. I don't know if I showed you this one. North Central Library, this is kind of nice, except for this stuff over here, but it's got a moving image here that, you know, you could kind of you can move. It's kind of nice. It adds a design feature. It's got links over on the side, which, we can work something out here. The calendar, the days, live help, which is kind of like what we have right now. Maybe we'd have to forego the accordion type boxes that we currently have. This might work better just to have a direct link to Zoom. And then items here, learn from about the library. We don't have an active calendar. That might be a neat thing to have, but again, but it does have those drop down boxes here. And that, again, might be a problem. These are exactly the kinds of things that we would probably want: A to Z databases, or research help, or services, which would be like interlibrary loan. You'll see a lot of the same stuff comes up. These are like best practice type things that you find in many library websites. I'm gonna go back to was it Worcester State, or was it Williams, because again, this site had these really nice. It can be really small. I mean, it can be really compact, and then you open it up, and this is like your accordion boxes, for to link to guides, that we already have. We're already linking to guides, but I mean, this might just help with the that landing page being more precise. So I hope that this video helps you have a sense. I'm going to send you links to all of these sites. We're looking at other sites as well, but I wanted to kind of at least introduce you to what we're thinking of. And again, the most important thing is to have a place holder for that widget when we get it. I hope we're contacting you soon enough. I know that, we're hoping to have this up and running by, first week of September, preferably the third week of August. But it is already July. And we've been on hold with EBSCO, so we haven't been able to, we don't have that widget for you because they don't have it for us yet. But if we can meet at some point, myself and you and Richard, that would be great. And maybe some other folks from the library. Thanks so much. I look forward to talking to you, and I hope this helps you see exactly what we're looking for. Thank you.